Welcome to worship service here at Our Savior's Lutheran Church, both in person and online this morning. And a happy St. Nicholas Sunday. It is our second Sunday of Advent. Today we have our Lessons and Carols service at this worship service, so we're delighted to have you here. And I want to thank the choir and our musicians for a wonderful service. Also a reminder, right after worship, please join us for coffee and treats. And then for adult education today, I invite you to stay and join with Don Leathers and Jason Baskin. They'll be our featured speakers talking about faith in the public square. And don't forget, Yule Fest is this Sunday, so I hope you have signed up for that. I think you can still, or this Wednesday, sorry. It even says Wednesday here, and I read the wrong thing. This Wednesday, and I think you can still sign up. I think the sign-up sheet is still out there, but this is your last chance, so please do so. I think we're getting close to 100 at this point, so please do that. Other than that, those are the announcements, and we're going to begin by singing our hymn, We Will Remain Seated, and that is hymn number 263, Savior of the Nations, verses 1 through 4. Over 100 people from the ages of 2 to 80 years old were asked the question, what are you afraid of? From the voices of different generations, hear their answers.
Not being enough.
Not making enough of a difference.
Falling down.
That we will forget we belong to one another.
Climate change.
My child having to learn gun violence drills at school.
Spiders.
Not having someone to take care of me. Not having someone who knows my stories.
My mental health slipping.
Ending up alone.
Nightmares.
Stopping short of following God all the way.
Today, we light the candle of peace because we so desperately need God's peace in the midst of all we fear. May this light be a reminder that Christ is coming, the advent of our God. God was with generations before. God is with us today, and God will be with us tomorrow. Even now, God is on the way. Amen.
Holy God, whether it's through angels or music, friendships or sermons, study or nature, when you speak, we long to hear it. In a world as chaotic and broken as ours, we could use your words of hope and healing. With gratitude we pray. Amen.
Reading from Matthew. Now the birth of Jesus the Messiah took place in this way. When his mother Mary had been engaged to Joseph, but before they lived together, she was found to be with child from the Holy Spirit. Her husband Joseph, being a righteous man and unwilling to expose her to public disgrace, planned to dismiss her quietly. But just when he had resolved to do this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what had been spoken by the Lord through the prophet. "Look, the virgin shall conceive and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke from sleep, he did as the angel of the Lord commanded him. He took her as his wife, but had no marital relations with her until she had borne a son, and he named him Jesus. Word of God, word of life.
Thank you. Reading from Luke. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration that was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. Word of God, word of life.
In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those whom he favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from Luke. So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and the child lying in the manger. When they saw this, they made known what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all of these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen as it had been told to them. Word of God, word of life.
The peace of Christ be with you always. We share a sign of God's peace with one another this day. We worship God with our offering.
Thank you.
Holy God, we take a deep breath. We take it in and know that you are here. For where two or more are gathered, you are there. You never leave our sides. Like a protective mother hen or the sun who circles the earth, you carry us with you. So today, we bow our heads with tender spirits and ask that once more you would lean in close. Hear our prayers. Buoy our hearts. Send your spirit rushing through us like a mighty wind. For these days, God, we have much to fear. Name fears that are applicable to our community at this time, and these are what we shall use for examples. And I'll pause each time as we think on these and as those you may hold in your hearts. For example, we fear the return of a COVID variant that could once again shut down the world. We fear the rising tide of violence. We fear global warming. Will our grandchildren have trees to climb? We look at our own lives and are afraid that we aren't making much of a difference, that we might be forgotten at the end of the day. We fear rejection. We fear grief. We fear not being enough. Holy God, the muck of our lives is deep. At times it feels like we're swimming in it. And so we come to you today because you are a God who said, "Do not fear," 365 times in Scripture, once for every day. You are a God who has inserted yourself into the corners of our lives, refusing to let us go, refusing to leave us alone. And so we rest in that. We empty our pockets of our fears, and we give them to you, trusting that you will hold them tenderly, just as you hold us. You whisper, "Be not afraid." You promise to never leave our side. You call us beloved. May that be enough for today. And now, with hope in our hearts, we pray the words your Son taught us to pray, saying, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen."
Love Comes Running by Sarah R. Speed. I remember the first time I was afraid. I was a child. It was a nightmare. You remember those pesky monsters under the bed? I remember minutes feeling like hours. I begged the sun to rise. Fear always begs the sun to rise. Eventually, after minutes that felt like hours, I cried out. My dad came running. He sat at the edge of my bed. He said, "There's no reason to be afraid." He checked the closet and the floorboards. He rearranged my pillows. He said, "I can stay." And that's when I learned that when you're afraid, love always comes running. Love says, "I can stay." That's what God does for us. God sits at the edge of the bed. God checks the closet and the floorboards. He says, "Be not afraid." God stays until sunrise. Love always comes running.
As you leave this place, may you go knowing that from generation to generation, we've been claimed and loved. From generation to generation, God has been by our side. From generation to generation, we are not alone. The God of yesterday and the God of tomorrow knows you by name, loves you, and calls you forth, saying, "Go be the person you are called to be. Love wildly, do justice, and come back soon." May it be so. Amen. The Holy Gospel of John, the first chapter, verses 1 through 5. Enarche en hologos. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. Word of God, word of life, thanks be to God.
Thank you. go in peace with Christ beside you.
Thanks be to God.